traditional data structures are solving very general problems. They are used by anyone. They are the lingua franca of the programmers, but we are not solving general problems. We are solving very specific problems. It doesn't really extend the user experience. It enables a whole new workflow, is what I would say. I'll tell you a toy example. Let's imagine that we build a model of a car. And we build the model of the car by first starting with a single rectangle, which will be the size of the car. Now, if we did the modeling in a good enough way, what we can do is modify the base rectangle of the car, and the whole car will change shape according to this. This is only possible with time traveling modeling. Of course, people won't design cars this way, but for example, tweaking the position of buttons on a coffee machine can be done the same way without needing to remodel the whole coffee machine, which you would need to do otherwise. Our team deals with less of the user-facing stuff and more of the low-level stuff. But this means that we are increasing the performance of the application, we are increasing stability, and these are blockers for the users, right? Like if the software is not stable enough, it's not the question of whether they like to use it or not, they are literally unable to use it. So we are mostly removing blockers that enable us to serve more customers as well as they want us to. The main point is that we have more control. It's not even necessarily true that native C++ code is much faster than other languages, but whenever we see something as a performance bottleneck that slows down the application way too much, we are able to act on it, which may or may not be true in other languages. We can always reduce the number of memory allocations at a certain code path, or implement data structures by ourselves, which are in certain languages impossible, or at least will never be as fast as the standard variants. This is not true here. First of all, measure a profile and make sure that this is actually the fault of the standard solution. And it's not an accidental complexity increase. It's very easy to make an algorithm O(n) squared instead of O(n) by making an accidental copy, for example. Switching out standard solutions for non-standard ones shouldn't be the first idea one has, but sometimes, of course, we have to do it. And I think in this case, a lot of experimentation and very diligent testing of the implemented data structure are the most important parts, because even if we experiment enough and find a very good solution, it still needs to actually work. And data structures are very easy to mess up. They are very generic, which is their main benefit and drawback as well. They can be reused over and over again, but because of their genericity, it's harder to implement them perfectly. In general, what I see is a push for a more functional architectures. Persistent data structures not long ago have been a full, only academic thing. But now there are libraries implementing these, which are actually usable in real-time situations, and these can heavily reduce the amount of work that an engineer needs to do to implement multithreading or undo redo, for example. So I think in the industry as a whole, maybe these will be some of the directions that that help evolve the industry.